Hey guys, Jengar here. Welcome to today's realistic review in which we are taking a look at the second Saab 105. This one is not the E, but it is the G. Also 8.7 battle rating. Now these planes are more or less identical. There is one big difference though from the premium one that this one doesn't have, and that is the combination of the gun pods and the missiles. You don't have that in this plane, so you have to choose. Do you want to take two AIM-9B missiles, or do you want to take two 30mm gun pods? Now you see, it's obvious what I chose, but you might want to make a different choice. Although two AIM-9Bs without any further fire support is choosing a lot for zero kills, I think. So it's not a viable option, just two 9 AIM-Bs. But anyway, that's my opinion. This plane is just slightly better in the acceleration department and the energy retention, and can fly a few kilometers an hour faster than the Saab 105E because it has less drag, because there is two missiles missing. So you have a maximum speed at sea level of 958 kilometers an hour. At 4500 meters, this is 746, and at 6500 meters, still go up to 653. Now, those are more or less identical to the Saab 105E, and not particularly fast at 8.3. As we already said, that plane, in the performance wise, it's on the edge of what the flight model can handle, so you are stretched. And the plane compresses a lot and it snaps wings when you make maneuvers at higher speed. So this is a little bit of a problem. And well, the flaps is something else. 450 ripoff for the flaps. Anyway, I'll get into that later. Top speed in a dive, 998 kilometers an hour before she redlines, and 1050 before she breaks apart. Now, the control stiffening is relatively nice, with the first tick in the roll rate compression at 650, elevator stays functional. And then at 800 you get a second tick in the roll rate, but there is also a big compression in the negative on the elevator. You really start to compress above 800 kilometers an hour, and it will be difficult at a certain point to pull out of a dive. Really, really big compression in the elevator in this plane at the higher speeds. And that is also a little bit the edge of what this flight model can handle. It cannot really handle these speeds. It's the same flight model as the SK60, and it just doesn't handle the top speeds around 1000 kilometers an hour very nicely. So yeah, you have that problem. The stall speed is quite nice with 110 kilometers an hour, and that is very acceptable. The firepower is good. Not great, like with the other one, which had missiles and the 30mm. This one just has the 30mm, and you could call that good to very good firepower. I love these two 30mm gun pods. You see a little bit of an example of the compression here. We're going 930 here. We barely avoid the ground. But still, the gun pods provide very good firepower. The ammo load is also very good. 150 rounds for 30mm gun pods is very, very nice. As we go to the acceleration and the performance, it's slightly better, but still falls in the same category as the Saab 105. Acceleration is good, both in a straight line and in a dive. And the energy retention is decent, both in the horizontal and in the vertical. Because of the absence of the gun pods, the missiles, or the gun pods, could be. Maybe you want to make that choice, who knows. But the absence of that gives it a little bit better, a little bit less drag, and a little bit better performance. Climb rate, but it's not really noticeable, to be honest. It is so small, but you feel a little bit when you're testing speeds and stuff like that, that it goes a little bit further and it picks up speed initially a little bit nicer. It's just a little bit less drag, and that's always good. It's also noticeable in the climb rate, which is very good, and the roll rate is nice, as you see here, against an ME163. Yes, couldn't see that. Dark evening map, I guess. The turn time in the plane is decent to good with flaps. The problem is that the flaps rip off at 450 kilometers an hour, which is of course very, very early. This is a bit of a problem for this plane. 450 is not even good for a later prop in the rip speed for the flaps, let alone this jet fighter. But yeah, that is what it is. You've got an excellent roll rate in this plane. Really helps with the maneuverability overall, because it does give you survivability. As you just saw, it's very possible to make a rolling overshoot on an enemy plane and defend yourself that way. The roll rate in the plane, tired, I guess, after my night shift. My brain is not functioning. Maneuverability, very good overall. And you do have overheating, which is a little bit of an issue. When you fly the plane at 100 kilometers an hour, you will get the overheating a lot, and quite quickly as well. You just take off from the airfield and you will already have this overheating almost, and already in the amber often. So you gotta fly it at about 98-97% usually, and then bring it up to 100 in dogfights to give that extra little boost in performance. And you've got to do that because you don't want to go into the amber into a dogfight and then turn completely red and kill yourself in that dogfight, because initially it will not be a problem, but extended dogfights will be. Durability is decent, but there is wing snappability because the plane is on the edge of what this frame can handle, and that is well, it can be problematic once you go at a higher speed in dives and stuff like that. And pulling high Gs, this plane just doesn't do it. It will rip off the wings and your match will end. Or you can maybe continue to fly. It doesn't always give you a death. So maybe you can continue to fly and do a few head-ons, but your slight adjustments will already be a little bit difficult. So yeah, nobody can really fly with one engine tip off and expect to do well. Well, I know, I mean, there have been plenty of meme videos about people just doing just that, or ripping off both wingtips, but yeah, in a regular match, when you don't have too much time, that usually does not happen. And we really should have gotten this kill. Yeah, not enough lead, and we're gonna miss that shot, as we did. So, how should we fly this plane? I think it's a little bit of a jack of all trades. She can boom and zoom, but she is limited in the top speed in a dive, so you got to make short boom and zoom runs. You have compression as an issue. You have the wing snappability as an issue. And you do have that frame that doesn't like these speeds very much. So all in all, the performance at higher speeds is not fantastic. And you really got to take that into mind. We did a little bit of spraying here, but that works. It worked. It's dead. I do miss half my ammo, though. In small detail. Energy fighting in this plane is also fun. It does well enough for that. With the exception in up tiers, it's not too great then. But she has more than decent performance in overall. And she can, do some good in the energy fighting department. Turn fighting she can also do against most jets. She will out-turn them. And that is a good thing. Of course, there's a few things that can give you some competition. Sabers turn pretty well. And at lower speeds, this one is better, though. And the MiGs in a flat-out turn are also quite good. But this plane is quite maneuverable for the feisty little thing that she is. And she can perform reasonably well in all three of the roles you can take as a fighter. You can also ground pound in the plane, of course. In ground derby it might be functional as well. It has rockets and the gun pods. Missiles if you want them, but no combo between the gun pods and the missiles. But there is other combos to look forward to. So you can definitely fulfill multiple roles, and it's a versatile little bugger, this trainer, that can give you a lot of joy when you fly her. The premium one is just pretty, here we go for compression, it's just a good bit better than this plane because of the combination with missiles and gun pods, and this one should basically be at 8.0 beta rating. It should be down tier. This one is too high with 8.3. We have Final Blow. I miss what that was. And Anti-Mech. Fantastic. I'll see you in the conclusion. Hey guys, so here we are after the match. Now this plane is enjoyable to fly. You can do a lot of stuff with her, but she has definitive downsides that you have to watch. The wing snap ability at high speed, maneuvering, stuff like that. Pulling high Gs, difficult. Rolling and pulling stuff, it's just gonna snap some wings off. You gotta be careful there. It's got overheating that you gotta take into mind. And the compression at higher speeds is an issue in this plane, which you really gotta take into mind, because that has killed me a few times, that compression. Really rough compression on the plane. But for the rest, he has good gun pods. He has the maneuverability is nice. Energy retention and acceleration are decent and too good. And it's going to do a bit of energy fighting. You can boom and zoom, short runs in that, and you can turn fight in her. So good roll rate for defensive flying and making overshoots happen. So overall, this is a feisty little bugger that is not in the right place at 8.3 beta rating, because mostly you will face missile planes and this plane doesn't have them. Well, she can have them, but you know, it doesn't have any other armament then after 2 9 aim Bs, and the Bs, well, you know, they're just not that good. So you may get one kill every match, but then you're done. You got to go back to base. That will not be very beneficial. So I really prefer and would advise you to take the gun pods first. You can try to combine the gun pods with something else, and see what you can do. But yeah, so it's a nice plane. I like it. Definitely worth it, but it should go down in battle rating to 8.0. Absolutely, guys. I hope you enjoyed the video. I want to thank you all for watching. And I'll see you guys next time. Bye bye. If you're new here, make sure to hit the subscribe button. Become part of this community. If you are already a subscriber, don't forget to like the video. Do leave me a comment. And if you really feel like helping out today, make sure to share the video with your friends and let them know about the channel.